One Zambia, one nation. My name is Lista Mtokwa to present our news at 18 hours. We take a look at what makes headlines. Three Zambia Wildlife Authority recruits have drowned at Chunga Wildlife Training School in Kafue National Park. President Edgar Lungu has sworn in Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Patrick Matibeni. And in sports, the Zambia under 20 girls handball team beats host South Africa 42-16 in their opening match of the ongoing International Handball Federation Trophy in Johannesburg, South Africa. Now the news in detail. Three Zambia Wildlife Authority recruits have drowned at Chunga Wildlife Training School in Kafue National Park. The three, identified as Jacob Piri, Chanda Chimfwembe, and Collins Ntondo, drowned during practicals on a man-made dam in the area. The other recruit, identified as Patrick Chambeshi, has survived and he is admitted to Mumbwa District Hospital. Police Deputy Spokesperson Esther Katongo has confirmed the development, saying an inquiry into the matter has been instituted. President Edgar Lungu has sworn in Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Patrick Matibeni. And President Lungu says Dr. Matibeni and all members of Parliament will be allowed the full enjoyment of rights and privileges accorded to them under the law. The President has also assured the Speaker that it shall be freely accessible to all members of Parliament. President Lungu said this in Lusaka at State House today when he saw in Dr. Matibeni. The head of state also saw in First Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, Catherine Namugala, and Second Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, Mwemba Malama. We have this in this report.
Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Patrick Matibeni, has taken oath of office before Republican President Edgar Lungu. First Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, Catherine Namgala, and Second Deputy Speaker of the National Assembly, Mwimba Malama, also took the oath of allegiance. The three were sworn in by President Lungu at State House in Lusaka after being elected by members of Parliament this morning. They were elected pursuant to Article 82, Sub-Article 6 of the amended Constitution and Standing Orders No. 4 and 5 of the National Assembly. During the swearing-in ceremony, President Lungu was categorical on the need to accord Dr. Matibeni and all members of Parliament for enjoyment of their rights and privileges under the law.
Be rest assured that you and all other members of the National Assembly would be allowed the full enjoyment of the rights and privileges accorded to you under the law, that I shall be freely accessible to members, and I shall at all times interpret their words and actions in the most favorable manner.
Elder Dr. Matibeni presented a petition that the President should allow MPs have free access to him.
Further, that you will be willing at all reasonable times to allow members free access to you, Your Excellency the President.
Since independence in 1964, Zambia has had six speakers of the National Assembly.
Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Patrick Matibeni, who is also former High Court judge, shot to the helm of Parliament in 2011. Meanwhile, First Deputy Speaker Catherine Namgala is former Community Development Minister and former Mafinga Member of Parliament under the MMD regime. And Second Deputy Speaker Mwimba Malama is former Muchinga Province Minister and former Mfue Member of Parliament. Hanok Kasama, ZNBC News at State House in Lusaka.
Earlier, Dr. Patrick Matibeni was unanimously re-elected as Speaker of the National Assembly. This was after he went unopposed in an election that took place at Parliament today. Both the ruling and opposition political parties have supported the candidature of Dr. Patrick Matibeni. The First Deputy Speaker, Catherine Namugala, and Second Deputy Speaker, Mwemba Malama, nominations also went unopposed. Clerk of the National Assembly, Doris Mwenga, who was returning officer, declared the trio duly elected. Luangwa Ward Councillor Evaristo Chilofia has been elected and opposed as the deputy mayor of Kitwe. Mr. Chilofia, who is serving his second term as councillor, was declared duly elected by Kitwe Town Clerk Bonwell Luanga when the city held its first full council meeting this morning following last month's general election. The meeting was presided over by newly elected Kitwe Mayor Christopher Kangombe. And Mr. Chilofia, who is the oldest councillor in the chamber, says he will humble himself and work with all the 25 councillors to develop the city in the next 5 years. Meanwhile, Mulu Ward Councillor of Bahati Constituency of Mansa District, Jennifer Mumba, has scooped the Mansa Deputy Mayor seat. In a voting process involving 21 councillors in the council chamber this morning, Mulu Ward Councillor Jennifer Mumba polled 11 votes against Mulenshi Ward Councillor Yota Mansa, who polled 10 votes. Returning officer, who is also Mansa Municipal Council Town Clerk Davis Walia, declared Ms. Mumba as duly elected deputy mayor for Mansa Municipal Council for the period 2016 to 2021. Roma Ward Councillor Chilando Chitambala has gone and opposed for the position of Lusaka Deputy Mayor. Ms. Chitambala went and opposed after Nkoloma Ward 1 Councillor Tasila Lungu withdrew her candidature this morning. Ms. Lungu had filed in her nomination of Deputy Mayor on Thursday. Lusaka Town Clerk Alex Mwansa told TV2 News in a telephone interview this afternoon that as at 17 hours, the council was only in receipt of one nomination. He says the nomination of Ms. Chitambala will now be forwarded to the council meeting on Monday, and Lusaka City Council Assistant Public Relations Manager Brenda Katongola said that the installation of the mayor and deputy mayor will be held on Monday. The Minister of General Education says a total of 108,595 candidates have obtained General Certificate of Education GCE certificates in the 2016 GCE examination. Minister of General Education Permanent Secretary Henry Tukombe says 37,050 were males, while 71,545 were female. Mr. Tukombe further said there has been an increase in the proportion of candidates that obtained GCE certificates from 90.38% recorded in 2015 to 92.91% in 2016. He, however, noted that the poorest performance was in mathematics and science. Mr. Tukombe also said there were no reported cases of examination leakages during the 2016 GCE examination. He, however, said a total of 186 suspected cases of examination malpractices were recorded mainly in form of assistance, and that results for the affected candidates have been withheld. Mr. Tukombe also said the 2016 GCE examination was the last to be written under the old curriculum. The Zambia National Education Coalition, ZANEC, has called on government to increase the budget allocation to the education sector in the 2017 national budget. ZANEC chairperson Kakunta Kavika says serious commitment is needed to fight illiteracy levels in the country. Mr. Kavika says a larger allocation to the education sector is key as the sector needs equipment to provide quality education. He says education is a human right that should be provided for every Zambian. Mr. Kavika said this in a speech read on his behalf by the ZANEC vice chairperson Geoffrey Simfokwe at the ZANEC Education Workshop in Lusaka today. Meanwhile, the Minister of General Education says deliberate policies are being put in place to realize adult literacy in the country. Minister of General Education Permanent Secretary Henry Tukombe says government is working on policies that will govern the sector. Mr. Tukombe said this in a speech read on his behalf by General Education Senior Curriculum Development Specialist Maria Nyirenda. Government says Eastern Province will soon become the food basket of the country. Plus, many other stories coming after this break. You're watching our news at 18 hours. We now continue with the news. Government says Eastern Province will soon become the food basket of the country. Eastern Province Minister Makebe Zulu says this follows government's move to increase power supply and construction of dams in the province. Mr. Zulu says with the construction of the dams, it will be easy for farmers to diversify their farming activities in the area. He says the coming of economic zones in the province will also contribute to value addition. Mr. Zulu said this when he featured on the TV2's Morning Live program.
And as you may have heard from the speech, the inaugural speech by the president, he intends that we move towards industrialization. So we are going to move towards that as well in Eastern Province. There's an area that has been identified to be a multi-facility economic zone, which is going to see a lot of structures coming in, a lot of industries being built, and we intend to use the Youth Development Fund, CEC, to encourage people to start their own businesses.
Government says it will strengthen partnerships and cooperation with meaningful organizations like World Vision in uplifting the lives of Zambians. Southern Province Assistant Secretary Luyanga Kapumo says such non-government organizations have helped the government to significantly address the underlying causes of poverty and injustices in rural Zambia. Mr. Kapumo says the government will continue to collaborate and support World Vision Zambia in its efforts to help fight poverty. He says through its various food security and economic development interventions, communities in Zimba and Kalomo districts have greatly benefited from World Vision. He said this at Chief Sipatunyana's Palace in Kalomo at the official closure of the World Vision's 16-year developmental programs in Kalomo Central and Zimba districts. More in this report.
Past 16 years, World Vision, in partnership with the Zambian government, carried out several developmental projects in Kalomo Central and Zimba districts.
Together, we have impacted an estimated number of 40,000 people in both Zimba and Kalomo districts. There is improved access to education facilities in the two districts today compared to 16 years ago. Improving maternal, child health and nutrition was also a key intervention. World Vision has worked effectively with the Department of Water Affairs and the community to establish, repair, and maintain water points. And this has resulted in 90% of people in the area having access to safe and clean water. Ensuring there is increased food security in the area was another area of interest.
And now, World Vision's partnership with government in the two districts has come to an end.
World Vision has significantly helped address the underlying causes of poverty and injustice in our societies. It has been a worthwhile partner and a genuine friend, not only to the people of Kalomo and Zimba districts, but to Zambia as a whole, as it has developed programs in all the provinces of the country.
Chief Sipatunyana of Kalomo District, in whose area World Vision has been active, appreciates the benefits his subjects have gained.
A visitor leaves a mark when the CIGCC. So World Vision, you have left a mark, and we will forever remember you. Now, government, you need also to be thankful for providing an enabling environment.
The government has assured World Vision of its continued support in other areas where it is still active.
I would like to assure World Vision of continued government support and collaboration. I wish to say that government welcomes any meaningful organization such as World Vision, and will do all it takes to strengthen partnerships and cooperations for the benefit of the people of Zambia.
Lives of the people of Zimba and Kalomo districts have greatly improved because of the many developmental projects that World Vision, working with government, has carried out in the two areas. It now remains with the people of Zimba and Kalomo districts, together with the government, to ensure that these gains are sustained. Elias Lungu, ZNBC News in Kalomo District, Southern Province.
Choppies chain stores are set to invest $37 million United States dollars in Zambia in the next 4 years. Choppies operational director Yotish Kanaradan said Zambia has proved to be a good investment hub in Southern Africa. He said Choppies will open 20 stores and will target high-density populated communities. He said this during the official opening of the 7th Choppies store in Zambia. And Chainda Ward Councillor Doris Moyo says the setting up of Choppies in Chainda will not only take development to the area, but also provide employment to young people. We find more in this.
Chainda Ward in Lusaka will never be the same, as one of the biggest chain stores in Southern Africa has set up its investment in the area. This is the 7th Choppies superstore in the country, and the store is scheduled to open 20 shops in the next 4 years. An investment of 36 million United States dollars will be pumped into this project.
At the moment, we have planned, our growth plan is just like for the next 4 years, we'll have around 40 plus outlets. And our core business is just like we wanted to provide goods and services to the areas where there is no proper retail development. Like we take business to the people rather than people coming to the malls and people coming to us. So we provide services in the townships where they are living. So it makes a convenient shopping for them.
And Chainda Ward Councillor Doris Moyo is happy with the investment. She said the investment in her ward means the creation of the much needed employment to the people of Chainda.
Inviting investments in many areas of business. So Choppies Management, I thank you for heeding to our government's call. As area councillor, I am very excited that by your choosing to invest in our area, you are not only bringing development to this area, but also employment opportunities to our many youths here.
And Chainda Ward residents are happy with the presence of the new shop, saying it will bring about competition.
And we hope it to create business opportunities for the locals as well as employment opportunities.
It's a good move to bring the business here in Chainda Ward. I think it will add value to the community.
Very happy. So this morning I wanted to go down, but when I saw people here, that's why I came here. I'm so happy.
The establishment of Choppies Superstore in Chainda Ward will with no doubt create the employment opportunities. Theophista Lungu, TV2 News in Lusaka.
The Zambia Gaming Association, ZGA, has appealed to the Minister of Finance to help remove coins close to 1,000 confiscated in gambling machines and put them back in circulation. Association Chairperson Noah Malungila says coins are property of Zambia, but some have been removed from circulation through being held up in about 800 gambling machines, popularly known as Bonanza, marooned in the ZGA warehouse. Mr. Malungila says his association has been appealing to the ministry to remove the coins from the machines confiscated for being operated illegally, but nothing much has been done. He has expressed concern that the machines are holding on to 1 kwacha coins, which are supposed to be in circulation. Mr. Malungila adds that failure by the ministry to work with the association has seen it give back some machines to owners after presenting documentation. He has, however, noted that a lot of machines which were being operated illegally are still being kept in the warehouse. We take another break after that. More news. Straight to foreign news. South Africa is about to become one of a handful of countries across the world that slap a tax on sugary soft drinks. Denmark has had one for decades and has recently been joined by Mexico and France. For health experts in South Africa, the tax will be good for long-term health, but many others think it may damage an already fragile economy. In sports, the Zambia under-20 girls handball team has hit the ground running after beating host South Africa 42-16 in their opening match of the ongoing International Handball Federation Trophy in Johannesburg, South Africa. TV2's Prince Chiyun reports that the girls proved good for the hosts throughout the game to record their first win. However, it was also an individual brilliance by Zambia's pivotee Elizabeth Ngondwe that helped the team to outshine the hosts. Zambia will tomorrow meet Zimbabwe in their second game. Meanwhile, the under-20 handball boys team are awaiting the arrival of Botswana and may play, or rather might play, later tonight. And finally, in sports, the National Paralympics Committee of Zambia, NPCZ, says it will work hard to revive the participation of the disabled in sports. NPCZ Interim President Lango Sinkamba says the participation of the disabled in sports had gone down because of wrangles that had engulfed the committee. Sinkamba says the wrangles had deepened to an extent of Zambia failing to send participants at the Rio Paralympics last month. He says the wrangles also led to the dissolution of the previous executive at the September 3rd, 2016 annual general meeting held in Lusaka. Sinkamba says his interim committee will also ensure that sanity is restored to Paralympics in the country.
We need to work as a team. We need to develop disability sport in whichever form, especially that the government in place is a listening government, and they're determined to see to it that issues of people with disabilities are given a priority. Secondly, we would like to see to it that within the shortest period of time, we call for a general conference that will put in place a committee which with a full mandate to run the welfare of disability sport. And also we want to see to it that we bring stakeholders on board, those we have lost.
And on this sporting note, we end our news at 18 hours. Here is what made headlines. Three Zambia Wildlife Authority recruits have drowned at Chunga Wildlife Training School in Kafue National Park. The three, identified as Jacob Piri, Chanda Chimfwembe, and Collins Ntondo, drowned during practicals on a man-made dam in the area. President Edgar Lungu has sworn in Speaker of the National Assembly, Dr. Patrick Matibini, and President Lungu says Dr. Matibini and all members of parliament will be allowed the full enjoyment of rights and privileges accorded to them under the law. And in sports, the Zambia under-20 girls handball team has hit the ground running after beating host South Africa 42-16 in their opening match of the ongoing International Handball Federation Trophy in South Africa in Johannesburg. TV2's Prince Chioni reports that the girls proved good, too good to the hosts throughout the game to record their first win. Join me at 20 hours for more news. For now, stay blessed.